Dr. Curtis, what are the treatment options that are newer agents for the prevention of stroke in atrial fibrillation patients?
The good news is that we do have new options. Patients who have been treated for atrial fibrillation in years past usually would be treated with a medication called warfarin. And the name of the medication is as important as knowing that that would require frequent blood tests. Patients had to alter their diet, and the doses would have to be changed. It did require the blood draw. So a lot of patients had difficulty complying with the medication and getting the dose adjusted just right to prevent stroke without increasing the risk of bleeding. The good news is that we have several new drugs now that are much easier to use. So we don't have the same requirement for blood testing. You don't have to keep adjusting the dose. We can decide on the dose from the start. And it's very simple to use these drugs. They're either once or twice a day. And so we are hopeful and expectant that compliance with taking these medications will be much better. So it's great that we have a newer option for treating patients with atrial fibrillation.
Absolutely. A lot of my patients with non-valvular atrial fibrillation, they're very appreciative for not having to go for blood testings.